reading a few very, very relevant portions from the Word of God.
今晚开始的时间呢，想同大家先睇几段嘅经文。
Starting in the book of Luke, the Gospel of Luke, chapter 9, starting at verse 23.
由第23节开始,
through verse 26.
23节到第26节。
And he said to them all, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily, and follow me.
耶稣又对众人说，若有人要跟从我，就当舍己，天天背起他的十字架来跟从我。
Well, whosoever would save his life shall lose it, but whosoever will lose his life for my sake, the same shall save it.
因为凡要救自己生命的，必丧掉生命；凡为我丧掉生命的，必救了生命。
For what does a man profit if he gain the whole world and lose himself or be cast away?
人若赚得全世界，却赔了自己，赔上自己有什么益处呢？
For whosoever shall be ashamed of me, and of my words, of him shall the Son of Man be ashamed, when he shall come in his own glory, and in his Father's and the holy angels.
凡把我和我的道当作可耻的，人只在自己的荣耀里，并天父和圣天使的荣耀里，降临的时候。 也要把那人当作可耻的。
And then please turn to Romans chapter 12.
然后请大家打开罗马书第十二章。
Read verse 1 and 2.
罗马书第十二章第一节和第二节。
I'll ask that we read in Cantonese and we'll just follow in English.
我们用中文来读罗马书第十二章第一节开始。 所以弟兄们，我以神的慈悲劝你们，将身体献上，当作活祭，是圣洁的，是神所喜悦的。你们如此侍奉，乃是理所当然的。不要效法这个世界，只要心意更新而变化，叫你们察验何为神的善良、纯全、可喜悦的旨意。May
God add a spirit of obedience to the reading of His Word.
当我们读神的话语嘅时间，求神都俾我哋有一个顺服嘅心。
Well, I've been thinking about coming to Hong Kong for about 17 years.
在过去17年，我已经多次谂过嚟香港。
And every time I thought about it,
我每一次谂起嘅时间，
I realized all the Christian workers that were here.
咁我就谂起喺呢度咧，都有好多基督徒嘅工作者。
And great Christian leaders and organizations.
咁又知道呢度有好多基督徒嘅领袖，亦都有好多基督教嘅机构。
I always felt this was at least one place that I did not need to go to.
所以我就想呢，这个地方呢，起码我自己觉得冇咁大嘅需要要我嚟到呢一度。
My heart has always been more captivated by the Middle East.
而我个心好多时间系俾中东嗰度嘅需要呢，好多时间俾我一个好大嘅迫切嘅负担。
And places like Afghanistan, I've probably visited about 30 times.
咁譬如阿富汗，我已经去过嗰度有大概30次咁多。
And you may be aware of the fact that in all of Afghanistan there are only about a few dozen believers in the entire nation of 18 million.
咁唔知大家知唔知道喺1800万嘅人口当中，喺阿富汗呢，只不过系有几十个基督徒。
And right now we're faced with the greatest opportunity ever to reach these people, as many of them are coming into Pakistan, which is a country that is more free.
咁但我发觉喺过去呢段短短嘅日子当中，有好多嘅难民由阿富汗涌入去巴基斯坦嘅时间，系制造咗一个好大嘅机会俾我哋能够向嗰度嘅人嚟到传福音。Of
course, being involved with the ship Lagos, I became somewhat involved praying more for Hong Kong.
由于我喺真道号嘅侍奉上面系有份，所以我自己亦都喺祷告当中有纪念到香港嘅需要。And
actually, I'm here now trying to get to Lagos.
咁其实我喺呢度咧，系等候上去福音呢度福音船真道号。
In order to have a special conference with the staff and crew while the ship is in dry dock over in Philippines.
就系当真道号去到菲律宾嚟到修理嘅时间咧，我有机会同真道号上面嘅童工系有一个嘅特别嘅退休聚会。
And it seemed that most of the flights, the good flights from London where I live, went to Hong Kong first.
咁我自己喺倫敦係居住嘅，咁但係似乎倫敦一啲好主要嘅飛機航線都要經過香港。So
I'm very grateful for this opportunity.
咁所以就俾我有一個咁嘅機會咧，係喺香港停留一個短嘅時間。
Has put you in one of the most strategically located nations in all the world.
咁喺世界各个地方，唔知大家有冇察觉到你系身处一个系非常有战略性嘅一个地方
？23 years ago, shortly after my conversion to Christ, God put it on my heart, to pray regularly for China.
23年前，当我信咗主冇几耐之后，神已经将一个负担放喺个心里边，系要为中国大陆嚟到祷告。
And today is somewhat of a historic day after 23 years of praying.
咁而家经过23年嘅祷告，好似进入历史另外一个嘅阶段。
That I've been able to spend one day over in mainland China.
所以今日呢个日子都系有好大嘅一个历史性嘅价值，因为今日咧，我系有机会系踏足喺中国大陆。
That's not very much time.
我虽然入去中国大陆唔系好长嘅时间。
But I'm afraid if I went there much longer, and the burden became much greater.I don't know what I would do.
但係咧，我擔心我自己如果喺度停留再耐啲，個負擔慢慢越嚟越強烈咧，我就唔知道個後果會點樣。
I'm sure many of you have a greater burden for that than I do, so that certainly will not be what I'm speaking about tonight.
咁我相信在座當中有好多嘅人對中國嘅同胞有更強烈嘅負擔，所以我亦都唔係會喺今晚咧以呢個做我講嘅主題。
I do believe the burden of every Christian is the whole world.
我相信我哋每一个基督徒都应该有一个负担，系能够接触到整个嘅世界。
And especially tomorrow night, I'm going to be sharing about some countries that I have been in and worked in, such as India, that I believe will be an encouragement in expanding your world vision.
咁特别系听晚咧，我会同大家系分享到我喺一啲唔同嘅国家里边侍奉嘅经历，譬如喺印度嘅经历。我相信会俾大家一个嘅鼓励同埋挑战，等大家扩阔你嘅视野。
In preparation for tomorrow night's ministry, it would be good if you could read this book.
咁如果你想为听晚嘅聚会嚟到做一啲嘅准备咧，请大家事先咧系睇完呢本书。
You could at least read through the section on the Middle East.
特别咧呢一本书其中有一段系讲到中东嘅。
And some of the Muslim countries.
或者一啲回教里边嘅国家。
One out of every seven people in the world is a Muslim.
喺世界嘅人口里边，七个当中有一个系回教徒。
Yet less than 2% of the missionaries in the world work among Muslims.
但喺世界嘅宣教士当中，只有2%左右咧，系向回教徒嚟到传福音。
And you'll see through this amazing book of information and prayer requests how so many of the most needy nations in the world, unbelievably needy, are Muslim countries.
如果大家花啲嘅时间嚟睇一睇呢本书嘅时间，你就会发觉喺世界咁多地方嘅需要当中，其中一个最主要嘅需要咧，就系呢啲嘅回教国家里边嘅人发出嚟嘅呼喊。
This book has now come out in a number of languages.
呢本书而家已经译成多种嘅语言。
But I think English will be the closest to home for most of you.
咁但系相信对在座当中嘅人嚟讲咧，读英文可能会最方便。
I'd like to also mention three other books that have meant a lot in our work around the world.
咁亦都喺呢个时间介绍，另外有三本书同我哋喺世界各地嘅侍奉系有密切关系。
The Calvary Road, which you can't come on OM supposedly until you read this book.
就系向各国他行嘅路。希望大家咧都系肯花时间嚟到睇呢本嘅书。
The Discipline Life, which we often use as a study book in our conferences.
咁我哋喺好多嘅聚会当中咧，都会用呢一本有纪律嘅生命呢一本嘅书咧，系嚟到做一个嘅主题嚟到研讨。
I don't know much about Hong Kong, but I can tell you in Europe, the greatest need in our lives is more discipline.
喺香港我唔知嘅情况点样，但系发觉喺西欧好多嘅国家，最大嘅问题就系过一个更加有纪律嘅生活。
Perhaps the only thing I can think of more important is worship, and that involves discipline as well.
咁或者我谂到另外一样更加紧要嘅一样嘅嘢咧，就系点样去敬拜。但系点样敬拜，亦都系涉及要有节制、有纪律。
And so it's a joy to recommend also this book on prayer and worship, called "Destined for the Throne," which I hope soon will also be in Chinese.
咁所以呢第三本书我介绍到咧，系主要讲到祈祷同埋敬拜。咁我相信呢本嘅书咧，好快脆亦都会被翻译成为中文。
I don't think most of us are aware of how many different dialects there are in Chinese.
咁或者我哋在座当中好多人都未必会知道咧，喺中国嘅语言当中有几多种嘅方言。
Even on the mainland today, we went from one town only 7 miles, and the people were speaking 2 totally different dialects.
咁我今日入去中国大陆嚟到做一个好短嘅探访嘅时间咧，就已经发觉虽然行咗只不过7里路，嗰两条村嘅人咧讲嘅嘢。方言是完全不同的。
By the way, I think at this time of the year, everybody must be going over there.
咁我相信接近呢个嘅时间咧，好多中国人都喺呢个时间会翻去大陆。
There was just a huge queue of people. Most of them had stereos and everything you could think of in their hands, carrying in.
咁我刚才咧嚟嘅时间都已经见到咧，哇，一条好长嘅龙。咁啊，有啲又拎住啲啊唱机啊、电视机啊，乜嘢都有齐啊，喺度排紧队翻去大陆。
This evening we're considering the subject of discipleship.
我今晚系会讲到一个题目，就讲到做主嘅门徒嘅问题。
And is it possible today?
就我哋话要训练门徒，究竟可唔可行嘅一样嘢呢
？And since I am very new. To most of you, I thought it would be good just to share my own testimony.
咁我相信好多嘅人咧对我都唔系好认识，所以我就想用我自己个人嘅见证咧做一个开始。
And bring into that some very important truths about discipleship.
咁就喺我个人见证里边嚟到带出一啲同训练门徒好有关系嘅一啲嘅真理。
I wasn't reared in a Christian home.
咁我唔系喺一个基督教家庭长大。
My grandfather was from the little country of the Netherlands. He was an atheist. He didn't believe in the existence of God.
咁其實我父親咧出生嘅家庭，佢自己嘅背景係一個無神論者。
My other grandfather was from Glasgow, Scotland.
咁我另外我母親咧就喺蘇格蘭嗰度嚟出生。
He was a drunkard.
咁佢自己咧係醉酒嘅。
And used to beat my grandmother so much that she finally divorced him.
咁甚至我個祖母咧係俾佢打到咧。结果是离了婚。
My own parents ended up near New York City.
咁我父母后来咧就迁居系去到纽约。
They were sort of very nice middle-class materialists.
咁佢哋咧就喺一个中产阶级咁样嘅家庭里边嚟到长大。
So by age 14, I was baptized into materialism.
咁所以由14岁开始嘅时间，我就已经咧系好似受洗，系加入咗呢个资产主义。
And by 16, I had three of my own little businesses.
咁所以到16岁嘅时间我自己已经开始咗我自己几种嘅事业。
And I hadn't remember ever having heard the gospel.
而喺个时间我竟然咧完全冇机会听过福音。
I went to church because there were contacts in the church. There were nice girls in the church.
咁我当时咧去教会，主要咧一方面系从嗰个商业嘅眼光，另外一方面系去识一啲女仔。
And I even became the president of the young people's group and the assistant to the pastor.
咁而且後來咧，仲做咗佢哋嘅青年團嘅副主席，做咗佢哋青年團主席，仲做埋咧嗰個牧師嘅助理。
I'm not sure if anybody in that church really knew Christ. It was more of a social club.
咁其實嗰間教會裏邊，我望翻轉頭咧，未必有一個人係真正認識基督嘅。嗰度只不過係一個社交性嘅集會。
But there was a godly woman near the school that I was attending.
咁我嗰陣時翻學嗰度附近咧，就有一位好敬虔嘅婦女。
She had been praying for that school for 15 years.
咁佢已經有15年咁耐咧，係為嗰間學校嚟到禱告。
Not only that people would be converted to Christ, but that from that school they would go to many parts of the world.
佢嘅禱告就係話喺嗰間學校裏邊讀書嘅人能夠認識基督，而且神喺嗰間學校裏邊係差派一啲嘅人係出去傳福音。
And then when I went to that school, she began to pray for me.
咁我就入咗嗰間學校讀書之後咧，呢位婦人就為我嚟到祈禱。
And she prayed for me for 3 years, and every year I got worse.
咁佢連續三年不斷嘅嚟到為我祈禱，但似乎呢三年當中我自己係每況愈下。
And she sent me part of God's word, a Gospel of John, through the post.
咁有一次咧，佢就寄咗一本約翰福音俾我。
And as I read this gospel, God began to deal with my frozen heart.
咁當我開始睇呢本嘅約翰福音嘅時間咧，神就開始喺我冰冷嘅心裏邊嚟到動工。
Then also she put a rack of gospel tracts in the local railway station.
咁佢咧呢位妇人亦都将一沓嘅福音单张就放喺邻近嘅一个火车站。
And one day on the way to the doctor, actually, I picked up a little tract from that rack that God also used to speak to my heart.
咁有一次咧，我就去睇医生，经过火车站咧，就拎咗一张单张嚟到睇。咁神就用嗰张嘅单张，亦都对我讲说话。
Now I was often buying pornographic literature.
咁我當時咧，其實睇好多係色情嘅刊物。
And one day when I went to get some of this, there was a different magazine in the same place about Billy Graham.
咁嗰有一次咧，我就去買嗰啲色情嘅刊物嘅時間，就發覺喺嗰度咧，同樣嘅位置裏邊竟然出咗一本雜誌咧，係介紹葛培利。
So again, literature was to be used of God to work in my life.
咁神又使用刊物咧嚟到對我講一啲嘅説話。
This is one of the reasons I have a slight bent.Toward Christian literature.
咁所以我对基督教嘅文字工作咧，系一直以嚟都似乎有一种嘅偏爱。
I was so thrilled to see the book display. I always feel a little unhappy preaching if there's no book display.
咁所以我見到嗰度擺一個書攤咧，我就好高興。好多時間我講到咧，如果發覺嗰度冇乜冇個書攤喺度咧，我唔係好安樂。
On Saturday, I had a little conference with the navigators in London.
咁就冇幾耐之前咧，我喺倫敦同導航會嘅一班嘅同工係有一個嘅聚會。
It's a great Christian group that specializes in man-to-man follow-up.
咁導航會佢哋其中一個主要嘅事工咧，就係人對人、人跟人嘅一個栽培工作。
And several hundred came together.
咁當時咧係有幾百位佢哋嘅同工係聚集一齊。
So we set up great piles of books。
咁我哋咧喺個時間咧就有好多嘅書堆咗喺度。
And in that one day we saw 7,000 Hong Kong dollars of books sold。
咁就喺嗰一日咧，我哋賣咗7,000元書。
Just from two small tables。
咁就只不過兩張書台咁小嘅地方擺書啫。
I discovered everywhere in the world that somehow God is moving and giving people.A concern to read Christian books.
我發覺神喺各國嘅地方都係俾人係有一個嘅負擔嚟到睇一啲好嘅基督教嘅文字。
Now, as I read this magazine about Billy Graham,
咁嗰次當我打開嗰本雜誌嚟到睇到介紹到葛培理嘅文字嘅時間
，I didn't know anything about that kind of thing.
咁以前我從來都冇接觸呢類嘅文章。
But because he played sports and was married, he seemed at least partially normal.
咁由於咧佢亦都係有結婚，咁另外一樣嘢咧就發覺佢亦都對運動有啲喜好嘅，所以對我嚟講發覺佢都幾正常。
So when Billy Graham came to New York City，
咁所以有一次葛培理嚟到紐約嘅時間
，Partly out of curiosity， I went to see and hear him。
咁由於一種嘅好奇心嘅促使咧，我就去睇下佢同埋聽下佢。
Of course， this lady had been praying， others had started to pray。
咁由於嗰一位嘅婦人一路嘅禱告咧，亦都有其他嘅人咧開始亦都為我祈禱。
That night I heard the gospel。
嗰一晚我就聽到呢個福音。
And I experienced conversion through Christ。
亦都第一次經歷到同基督個人嘅接觸，佢改變咗我。
And I went back to that school。
我翻返去嗰間學校。
And God began to work in a very unusual way。
神就開始喺我身上邊好特別咁嚟到工作。
As I shared with other students,
咁當我同其他嘅同學嚟到分享嘅時間
，a few came to Christ.
有一啲人竟然信主。
Then we decided to distribute Gospels of John to the whole school.
咁我哋就開始有一個負擔咧，係將約翰福音係分發俾全校每一個嘅同學。
This, of course, there were very few Christians in the school. This was a very unheard of thing.
咁嗰間學校好少基督徒，從來都未人試過係咁樣做。
There were hardly any teachers who were Christians.
連先生都冇幾多個話係基督徒。
Somehow we got this permission, and 1,000 students promised to read the whole Gospel of John.
咁我哋竟然得到咧，成千嘅學生係答應咧，係願意睇曬約翰福音。
One of my many burdens is that everybody in the world should have at least one portion or one of the Gospels.
我自己其中一個負擔就係全世界每一個嘅人。起碼佢哋都能夠擁有聖經其中一部分，或者最低限度能夠睇一睇福音書。
Before a year or two, some 200 students in that school surrendered their lives to Jesus Christ.
過咗一兩年，接近有200個學生喺嗰間學校係信主。
Now some of you know about the ship Lagos.
咁我相信大家亦都聽過真道號呢隻福音船。
Some of you here have worked on the ship.
呢度咧，仲有啲嘅人咧，曾經喺真道號嚟到工作添。
In two or three years, you will get to know the ship Doulos.
咁再過冇幾耐咧，就有另外一隻 Doulos 呢隻船會出現。
We hope somehow in a couple of years, we may be able to bring this bigger ship here to Hong Kong.
我哋都希望有一次咧，能夠呢一隻更大隻嘅福音船咧，都能夠到香港。
But some of you may not know that story that I just told you, which is a true story.
咁或者大家都未曾聽過我所講呢一個係真實嘅故事。
Which is how the whole work of the ships and operation mobilization was born.
就係話呢隻船福音船係點樣開始，或者整個福音總動員呢一個嘅工作係點樣開始。
One woman
係一個婦人。
One disciple
一個門徒。
Who knew reality in prayer?
佢哋相信禱告嗰個嘅可信性。
Who had compassion?
而且佢哋有一个迫切爱人嘅心。
Who knew the reality of persevering and pressing on, even when things seem discouraging?
而且当情况似乎好恶劣当中，佢哋仍然系坚忍嘅、坚定嘅坚持落去。
And they, of course, are just a few of the marks of a true disciple.
而呢几样嘢只不过系一个真正嘅门徒其中一啲嘅标志。
Sometimes we think of a disciple as sort of a a young man moving out down the street preaching or giving out tracts.
我们可能心目中想的一个门徒呢，就有一个充满火热的心，很大的热诚，是能够去到街头上面来到派单张来到报道这样一个青年。
But here's this disciple is an unknown elderly lady quietly in her own home literally making an impact on the world through prayer.
但我们发觉在这个角落头，一个没人认识的一个老妇人，在他自己的房间里面，他透过不断的祷告，竟然能够震撼整个世界。
One of the most powerful books I've ever read on prayer is called Power Through Prayer.
在我读过关于祷告的书当中，其中一本最令我受心感动的就是《祈祷出来的能力》这本书。
I just noticed some on the book table.
咁我刚才睇见书摊上面亦都有呢本书。
And the author says the church looks for better machinery, God looks for better men.
嗰本书就指出一样嘅嘢。今日的教会是找一些更加好的方法，但神是找一些更加好的人。
Men of prayer, women of prayer.
就是肯祈祷的人。
And to me, this is the greatest activity that the true disciple of Jesus Christ can be involved in.
而对我自己来说，一个真正的门徒最主要的活动就是祷告。
Well, a few of us continued praying in that school.
那在学校呢，我们有几个人就继续不断的来到祈祷。
But of course, we soon left and went on to university.
咁当然我哋冇几耐离开咗间中学咧，就入去大学读书。
At university, I was destined to read another, to meet another very dynamic disciple.
咁喺大学里边，我又碰到另外一位咧，系好有影响力嘅一位门徒。
His name was Dale Roton.
咁呢位先生。
And he is now the director of the second ship, the ship Dulas.
咁就我讲第二艘嘅福音船嘅负责人。
Originally, he was not involved with the ships.
咁其实咧，开始嘅时间佢系冇参与呢啲福音船嘅侍奉嘅。
Because he was leading our work in the Middle East, especially Turkey.
咁因为当时咧，佢其实主要嘅任命就系喺土耳其呢个地方嚟到服侍。
Some of you may know his book, The Logic of Faith, written especially for Muslims.
咁大家或者有听过佢写嘅一本书，系特别为一啲嘅回教徒嚟到写嘅，就系讲到信仰嘅逻辑。
He then led our work into about 7 of the Soviet countries.
咁而且咧，佢就将我哋呢个福音总动员嘅工作系带进七个系苏联统治影响之下嘅国家。
Went back to university and picked up one or two more degrees.
咁佢读完书，继续咧喺大学里边系进修。
And we thought, well, maybe he's going to become a professor.
咁我有一段嘅时间咧，就谂住佢可能咧读完呢啲嘅书，攞多几个学位咧，可能想做教授。
But in an amazing way, God put the second ship on his heart, and that's where he and his family have now settled down, as the leaders of the second ship.
但系估唔到神系带领佢咧，系愿意喺上呢一艘嘅福音船里边嚟到工作，而且佢系带埋一家人咧，系上去嗰度侍奉。
When I met Dale at university, he was older than me.
咁当时我认识 Dale 呢位嘅朋友嘅时间咧，佢。
And I saw reality in his life.
我就喺佢嘅生命里边睇见一啲好真实嘅嘢。
You know, this would speak stronger than anything else, even stronger than literature. A life that's on fire for God.
比文字对我影响更大嘅，就系一啲俾神接触到而火热嘅生命。
Of course, some people didn't like him.
咁好多时间我亦都可能会接触到一啲嘅人。
When I first arrived at the college, they warned me, said, watch out for this fellow, he's even baptizing people in the showers.
咁我去读书嘅时间咧，已经有人向我提出警告，小心呢个人啊，呢个人咧四围捉人洗礼，有阵时咧喺冲凉房嗰度都帮人洗礼。
Which I thought was rather unusual since he was a Presbyterian.
咁而且咧，即系佢系长老会嘅背景，我就觉得佢咁样做法似乎好出奇。
But I went to a prayer meeting that some students were having.
咁有一次咧，我就参加一个学生几个学生一齐嘅祈祷会。
And I saw again reality in their lives.
我喺呢班嘅学生当中，亦都睇到一啲好真实嘅事。
Dale and I have now been locked together for 23 years.
Dale 同我咧，23年嚟，神将我哋系紧紧嘅连喺一齐。
I think, in fact, very few people have ever understood Operation Mobilization.
或者很多的人对这个福音总动员这个的工作未必会很了解。
Some thought it was a literature agency.
有些人以为这个只不过是一个文字报道的事工。
Then after that, some thought it was a shipping company.
有些人还以为是一间很大的轮船公司。
And all kinds of different ideas.
咁有好多唔同嘅睇法。
And all these things to some degree are true.
咁但係呢啲咁嘅睇法可能都有少少係啱嘅。
But as I look back over these past 25 years since I came to Christ,
咁但係我發覺我信咗主25年以嚟，
I think the key thing that stands out in my mind is that Operation Mobilization is a fellowship.
我自己嘅心目中嘅福音總動員呢個嘅機構，其實係一個團契。
A fellowship of people from all over the world who have been drawn into a very deep relationship with one another.
呢一班嘅人係喺世界唔同嘅地方係嚟到，但係係喺主裏邊有一個好緊密嘅聯繫同埋團契。
There are now about 200 to 300 leaders in OM.
而家呢？在福音总动员这个机构里面是有二三百位的同工，
and over 100 of them have been together for many years.
超过一百位是已经有很多年是一起来到侍奉主。
Even though one of our greatest joys is always when another one of our main leaders gets led into another fellowship.
那也很多时间我们当中的这个同工是被神带领是进入另外一个事工，也都令我们的心里面是很兴奋和快乐。
In fact, just 2 weeks ago,
其实两个礼拜之前，
In a small church, we were having a sending off meeting for one of our workers.
咁喺一间好小嘅教礼拜堂里边咧，我哋有一个差遣嘅崇拜。
To become a full-time worker in the International Evangelical Students, this brother's fellowship.
咁就差遣我哋当中其中一位嘅同工咧，系入咗国际学生福音团契。
Working under Chua Wei Hin there in Europe.
就喺蔡伟贤弟兄嘅领导之下嚟到服侍主。
And one of our greatest burdens is to just be able to lock hearts and lock arms with all of God's people around the world for the cause of world evangelism.
神俾我哋一个负担，就系同世界各地唔同嘅人都有一个同一个负担，靠着神嘅恩典，将我哋嘅生命，将我哋嘅心系连结一齐嚟到将呢个福音系传开去。
Well, about 8 months later.Dale Rotan, myself, and one other brother headed overseas to Mexico.
咁八個月之後咧，就 Dale 就有一次咧，就同我係商量過之後咧，就想到係去到墨西哥呢個地方。
We were just students.
咁當時咧，我哋仍然係學生。
And back then, this kind of thing was not done.
咁當時以一個學生身份話去到咁遠嘅地方咧，係好少人敢做。
Somehow we felt we must go and just work with missionaries and learn.About other cultures and the language as well.
咁但當時神俾我哋一個負擔，就願意去到一個唔同嘅地方嚟到學習另外一個嘅文化，嚟到學習點樣喺佢哋當中嚟到服侍。
This was one of the birthplaces of short-term missionary work.
咁喺個時間咧，其實可以講話就係短期宣教士誕生嘅開始。
We were received especially by the Wycliffe Bible translators, another great fellowship of God's people.
咁當時惠克利夫聖經翻譯會咧，係俾我哋有好好嘅接待，仲有其他嘅機構都係俾我哋好大嘅幫忙。
And we saw God answer prayer.
我哋就睇到神點樣嚟到答應禱告。
You know, already we were getting so much into our heads as Christians.
其實我哋做基督徒好似將好多嘅知識擠喺腦袋裏邊。
Dale was memorizing the New Testament.
Dale 當時是將新約聖經是逐卷逐卷來唸。
He soon had almost half of it committed to memory.
差不多半本新約聖經是被他唸完。
We were studying the Word of God, we were reading Christian books.
我們當時不斷地讀神的說話，我們讀很多基督教的文字。
But how do you get this into practice?
但是怎樣將這些知識化為行動呢？
And when you're 19, as I was,
我當時只不過19歲。
Just before I went to Mexico.
我喺去墨西哥之前只不过19岁。
You know what hope is there for you at that age?
19岁嘅人能够做一啲乜嘢？
Everybody was saying, you know, study harder, study longer, go to cemetery, seminary, etc., etc.
好多嘅人都系劝你系读多啲书，啊，一路继续嘅系深造，或者系入去神学院，或者入去。
And I found that I was getting bigger and bigger in the head.But my heart was not growing at the same pace.
咁當時就發覺我個頭似乎越嚟越大，但個心逐漸嘅萎縮。
Maybe this is a problem more in the West.
或者我哋以為呢個係只係西方人嘅問題。
We get men who are big-headed theologically, but their hearts, when it comes to compassion and love and reality, are often small.
我哋發覺有好多頭大大嘅神學家，但個心裏邊係好少愛心嘅表現。
And then how would we learn to communicate cross-culturally?
咁样嘅时间，我哋点样能够学习系超越一个文化，将我哋嘅信息嚟到传递出去呢
？I was studying Spanish at university。
当时喺大学咧，我有学到一啲嘅西班牙文。
Both my professor and I were getting discouraged。
咁当时咧，我嘅教授同我都好灰心。
It did not seem that I had language ability。
咁当时好明显一样嘅嘢咧，我冇乜语言嘅天才。
I was doing better in history。
我就对历史反而咧，似乎有啲比较好啲嘅表现。
In Mexico, and I was preaching in Spanish.
咁但我去咗墨西哥一个月之后，我可以用西班牙文嚟到讲道。
It can be very helpful.
啊，竟然对我好大有好大嘅帮助。
My guide, he was speaking Spanish. I don't understand this.
好奇怪，今日咧我去中国大陆嘅时间咧，嗰个导游者竟然都识讲翻几句西班牙文，我都好奇怪。
May not think you can ever learn a foreign language like Arabic or Turkish or Pashto or some other language.
或者我哋当中好多人都以为我哋永远唔识学另外一种嘅语文，特别一啲古怪一啲嘅，好似土耳其文啊、阿拉伯文啊呢啲咁样嘅文字。
But once you get into that environment where that's all these people are speaking, you will discover that the God will give you the gift of languages.
当你发觉你系委身投身喺一班嘅人都系讲嗰种嘅语言当中嘅时间。透过神的力量，神会俾你学习得到嗰种嘅语言。
Do not be discouraged in your language study, whatever language you're studying.
所以无论你喺度读紧一啲乜嘢嘅语文，你唔好灰心。
A number of our men have proven that the first three, four languages are the hardest. After that, it's easier.
咁我哋当中好多人都可以做个见证，佢哋初初学最初嗰三四种文字咧，就似乎复杂一啲，以后再学落去咧，好简单。
Almost without planning it, OM became a massive program.Teaching literally thousands of people their second, third, and fourth languages.
咁我哋本来咧系冇咁样计划嘅，但系发觉后来福音总动员呢个嘅机构咧，系开始训练嘅人好多人嚟到学习好多种嘅语言，唔止一种，系两种、三种、多种嘅语言。
Let me make a long story now very short.
本来一个好长嘅故事，但我要将佢缩短一啲。
Began to grow in Mexico.
个工作喺墨西哥慢慢嘅长大。
And then it spread to a closed land, the land of Spain, which at that time was closed to the outward proclamation of the gospel.
咁当时另外西班牙咧系对福音嘅传播咧系关闭，咁但系竟然道门都打开咗。
Literature had to be distributed secretly.
咁当时咧系分发一啲文字或者单章，系要喺暗地里边先至可以进行。
So we sent it out through the post.
咁所以当时我系仲用邮寄嘅方式嚟到寄出好多嘅单张。
In one and a half years, 900,000 pieces of literature went out through the mail。
咁过咗一年几咧，系有我系寄出咗900,000份嘅文字。
And Spaniards began to move, in reaching others for Christ。
咁当时亦都有一啲嘅西班牙嘅信徒开始，亦都系向佢哋周围嘅人嚟到传福音。
And it was Spanish young people who first took on this name, Operation Mobilization。
咁其實係一班嘅西班牙嘅信徒咧，佢哋係第一次係用呢個福音總動員呢個嘅名。
And they couldn't freely work in their own country, so they worked quietly all year. And in the summer, they'd launch out in evangelism in more open countries.
咁由於佢喺個佢哋嘅國家咧，係要做一啲嘅隱藏同埋地下嘅工作，所以佢哋開始咧就伸展出去其他傳福音更加自由嘅國家嚟到傳福音。
We had Spaniards moving on teams evangelizing Germany.
我系发觉有一队队嘅福音队伍由西班牙去到德国嚟到传福音。
It would be as if suddenly, you know, a team came from mainland China to evangelize Hong Kong。
个情况就好似由中国大陆派出一队嘅福音队伍嚟香港传福音一样。
But God used these Spanish young people。
但神使用嗰班西班牙嘅信徒。
Their faith triggered off a movement of God's Spirit in Great Britain。
佢哋咁样嘅传福音就开始咗喺英国。是挑起了另外一个运动。
In fact, in that first summer, 90 British young people, many of them university students, joined with the Spaniards.
就在那一年，有90位英国的学生就参加这一班西班牙的青年人，是到处去报道。
By the next summer, there were 2,000.
到第二个暑假呢，竟然有2,000个人是这样
做。900 from Britain alone launched out across the more needy European lands like Italy, Spain, France.
大概是有900个的英国的青年人是渡过英伦海峡，是去到欧洲一些更加大需要的地方，好像意大利，好像西班牙这些地方来传福音。
And this has been going on every summer.
而每一个暑假，这些运动都在这里进行。
Though soon the 1 and 2 year programs became more important as it gave a greater opportunity to do an in-depth kind of work.
后来慢慢发展下去的时间就演变成为一年和两年 为期的一些传福音的使命。
It was only in 1965 that the burden and the vision for the ship came.
那是到1965年我们先开始有这个意象来到开始这个福音船的工作。
Already a foundation had been laid.
那其实当时已经为这个工作打了一个基础。
And I think it's so important to understand that the miracle is not the ship,but it's what God has done in people's lives for more than 10 years before there was any ship whatsoever.
而我今天所看到的神迹并不是说有这架船的出现，而在这架船出现之前已经有成千成万的信徒是被神摸着而差遣他们出来。
Just a few days ago, actually on Friday, I was in Glasgow.
其实在没几上一个的星期五我在苏格兰 Glasgow.
In Scotland, and I was on the Dulas, the second ship.
咁我就喺呢个第二隻呢隻嘅福音船上边。
There are about 300 people on that ship living.
咁当时咧系有300个嘅童工喺呢架船上边嚟到居住。
It's 2 to 3 times the size of the Lagos.
咁呢第二艘嘅福音船咧系比较真道号仲要大两倍又多。
And yet once again I was made aware of this fact.
我当时亦都系感受到一样嘅嘢。
It's not the ship.
唔系呢艘船有咩稀奇。
The people.
是这班的人
the people that God has brought from all over the world,
就是神从世界不同的地方带来了这一班的人
to go through this discipleship training,
就叫这一班的人经过这个这样的门徒训练
to learn the reality of prayer,
叫他们能够学习得到祈祷的真实性
to learn the reality of loving all kinds of people regardless of race or nationality or anything else,
叫他们学习是爱世界不同背景不同文化不同种族的人
To learn how to effectively communicate cross-culturally to people of a totally different background.
而且要他们学习怎样向一些不同文化背景的人能够很清楚地来到传达我们这个信仰。
To learn the reality of books like Calvary Road and what it is to daily repent and live in revival at the foot of the cross.
而且学习怎样能够每一天回到神的面前能够过一个悔改是得到复兴是一个真正属灵的生命。
And I believe that the young people on these ships
我也深信这一班在真道号在这些福音船上面的青年
and the other 600 or 700 who work on shore
而且另外还有600-800个是上到去岸上来到工作的
are just one of many proofs that discipleship is possible today
这些只不过是其中一些的明证就告诉我们门徒训练是可行的一样的
not because they're perfect
并非因为这班的人是这么完美
not because they're special
亦都唔係因为呢班人有啲咩特别过人之处。
Because according to the New Testament, every true believer is a disciple.
因为我哋从圣经里面睇到，每一个信主嘅人都应该系一个主嘅门徒。
Discipleship is not some superior level of Christian living.
我哋唔好以为门徒系一啲高级啲嘅基督徒。
It's not something that only missionaries qualify for.
我哋唔系话净系嗰啲嘅宣教士先至配备称为门徒。
According to what I can see in the New Testament, every person once he becomes a believer.He is a disciple.
当我从圣经里面都得到这个了解就是每一个的人当他接受基督成为信徒的时间他们其实就是一个门徒。
It says in the book of Acts, the number of disciples increased.
在使徒行传那里告诉我们门徒的人数就加增。
That was Acts 6 verse 1. And then in verse 7 the same thing. The number of disciples multiplied in Jerusalem.
第六章第一节、第六章第七节都是这样讲，就是在耶路撒冷那里，门徒的人数就不断的加添。
It's not decisions God's looking for, it's disciples.
神不是说要找多一些决志的人数，神是要找多一些的门徒。
It's not a matter of just saying with your head that you believe in Christ, it's a matter of putting your life on the altar, as we read in Romans chapter 12.
我们并不是说举手来表示我们愿意做一个基督徒而是将我们的生命放在祭坛上面来表示我们愿意做一个跟随主的门徒
And the most amazing thing in the past few years
在过去几年当中令我最惊奇的一件事
is what is referred to in Europe in OM circles as the Chinese invasion
就在我们的团契当中我们就说这个是中国的侵略
Because in God's providence with the ship Lagos registered in Singapore
咁因为当时呢我哋就真道号呢喺新加坡嗰度呢係登记咗。
Even though we were the movement committed not to going any further than Bangladesh.
咁其实我哋当时呢其中有一样嘅心愿就话我哋去到最远呢就去到孟加拉呢个地方。
It was God's providence to overrule our little man-made decision and put us in Singapore.
咁但神 就超越咗我哋当时嘅决定，系叫我哋超越咗人所定嘅界线，系将呢个船带到去新加坡。
And then in Malaysia，
然之后去到马来西亚。
Just about a year ago when I was in Singapore，
一年之前左右我系去到新加坡。
We had a full-day conference called an Operation World Conference。
咁我哋当时就有一个世界总动员，我系咁样称呼佢嘅一个嘅聚会。
We had 1,600 young people there, serious young people for the whole day。
我哋喺嗰日有1,600个嘅青年人聚集喺一齐。
When I went to Malaysia, the response was even greater。
咁当我后来去到马来西亚嘅时间，个反应更加嘅热烈。
And now almost the third largest group within the whole OM worldwide are the Chinese。
咁所以喺福音总动员呢一个嘅机构里边，我系发觉喺童工当中系人数最多嘅，占第三位嘅系中国嘅童工，佢哋主要系喺马来西亚嚟，同埋新加坡呢两个地方。
In all fairness, just a few from Hong Kong.
咁而从香港去嘅咧，只不过系几个。
Maybe that's why I'm here tonight. I don't know.
或者神差我嚟呢度咧，可能嘅原因就喺呢度。
But when I found out the Malaysians are not allowed to go into mainland China, I was very disappointed.
咁后来当我发觉原来啲马来西亚嘅公民唔准进入去中国大陆嘅时间咧，我有啲失望。
The Malaysian government will not allow their citizens to go into mainland China.
原来马来西亚嘅政府系唔准佢哋嘅公民咧系入去中国大陆。
Singaporeans, I think, is a little easier.
咁新加坡嘅公民咧就似乎比较容易一啲。
From what I've seen today, those of you who have the privilege of being residents here.
咁或者我睇一睇，我哋有呢个咁样嘅权利做香港公民嘅人。
In most cases, are faced with one of the most unusual challenges, perhaps in the history of the church.
咁或者其实我哋所带住嘅面孔系对世界教会历史嚟讲系一个最大嘅挑战。
However, whether it's that mission or some other mission,
无论系乜嘢嘅使命
，if it's God's work, the first step is your own life.
无论系乜嘢嘅使命，第一步最紧要嘅系从你自己嘅生命开始。
It's not a matter of just running out and doing something.
我哋并冇话出去嚟到要做一啲嘅嘢。
The first step is always that our own life be brought into deeper reality with Jesus Christ.
第一样嘅嘢就系要我哋自己个人嘅生命系同主耶稣基督发生更加紧密嘅关系。
This is why in our work we want to remain a training program.
所以我哋嘅工作始终系保持呢个以训练为最主要嘅特色。
It's true we have many other aspects of our work.
冇错，我哋仲有好多其他方面嘅工作。
Especially in some Muslim countries.
特别喺啲回教嘅国家里边
，Where we're almost the only group functioning，
我哋系差不多系唯一嘅机构系可以进入呢啲嘅国家。
We have longer-term people. They speak the language fluently. Of course, I guess maybe they are no longer in training. Though we feel God's training, of course, is all of our life.
咁当然，在我哋当中有啲已经年资比较耐嘅一啲嘅童工，或者我哋对呢一班嘅人已经过咗训练嘅阶段，但其实我哋要学习嘅功课系一生之久。
People often talk about closed doors.
我哋好多时间都讲到一啲关闭嘅门户。
For 24 years of Bible study, I've been looking for this doctrine of the closed door.
咁我读咗圣经咧超过24年，我一路都揾下喺边度有门户关闭咁样一条嘅信条。
I have not yet found it.
我仲未曾发觉有边个地方咁样。
But if you can find it, you can also autograph my Bible at the end of the meeting.
如果你揾到有一啲嘅经文系同门户关闭有关嘅，好欢迎你嚟喺我本圣经嗰度签翻个名。
Everybody said for years, Afghanistan, a closed door.
好多嘅人曾经都咁样讲过，阿富汗就是一个门户关闭嘅国家。
The most fanatic country，
系一个接近疯狂嘅一个国家。
People accepted Christ within 24 hours they were dead。
如果佢哋接受基督嘅话，24小时之内佢哋可能就会生命系有危险。
But God opened the way。
但系神打开呢道门。
Gordon and Grace Magney have been there for 9 years。
我哋有一位嘅童工去到嗰度系有9年咁耐。
Of course they went as students。
咁佢最初入到去嘅时间系以学生嘅身份入去。
They got in the University of Kabul。
佢哋入到去阿富汗其中一间大学读书。
Of course, they were very slow students. Took them 9 years。
冇错，佢哋咧似乎读书读得比较迟钝一啲，读咗9年咁耐。
Turkey is another so-called closed country。
或者我哋话土耳其又系另外一个门户关闭嘅国家。
No official missionaries in Turkey。
喺整个土耳其嘅国土里边，我哋揾唔到有一个宣教士嘅踪迹。
We have a brother there in。One city，
我哋有一位嘅弟兄喺其中一个城市里边嚟到工作。
After he finished at London and Oxford universities，
咁当佢喺英国嘅牛津大学读完书之后
，he got a job in a university in Ankara doing brain research。
咁佢其實喺一間大學嘅研究院裏邊咧，做緊一啲同腦科嘅研究有關嘅工作。
Also a professor，
亦都成為大學嘅教授。
And then in his free time, he's planting a church among the Turks。
咁但係咧，佢喺佢工作之餘，佢係能夠有機會喺土耳其嗰度係開始一間嘅教會。
One of the few churches of converted Muslims in the whole nation， just a handful， just few。
咁喺佢整個國家裏邊嗰一間，差不多係唯一一間。的教会当中很多的人以前是回教徒
so there are many aspects of our work in which it's not just training
所以我们的工作当中有很多方面似乎看来不是训练那么简单
and even when people are in training when they are working under the right supervision through prayer they can be used of God to accomplish great things
咁即使一啲嘅人，佢系嚟到本来谂住接受训练嘅，但系喺神嘅引导同埋其他嘅同工嘅督导之下，神都使用呢班受训者能够完成好大嘅事。
2 years before we got the ship, we started our work in India, our main OM field in the world today.
咁喺我哋仲未有福音船之前嘅两年，喺印度呢个地方，其实印度系整个福音总动员呢个机构最大嘅工场。
Every year there were less missionaries in India.
印度。国内的宣教士人数是每年是减少。
And we were told again and again, this cannot be done, this cannot be done.
很多人都告诉我们在印度境内有很多样的东西都不容许来做。
But we first made our priority prayer.
但第一样东西我们注重的就是祈祷。
Secondly, we determined that the whole work must be built on our Indian national brothers.
第二样东西我们觉得我们整个工作必须要以印度的信徒为主要的骨干。
And that we as foreigners,must serve them and humbly work with them and under them.
而我哋呢啲外国嚟嘅宣教士就必须系要服侍呢一班嘅印度嘅同工，我哋必须系要向佢哋嚟到学习，嚟到支持佢哋。
The people said, "But you're not going to find the strong men of integrity to lead this kind of work."
或者我哋话喺本土系好难揾到一个嘅人系能够可以信任得过佢，叫佢能够领导起整个工作。
You say, "God, is this too hard for you?"
或者我哋话对神嚟讲，咁样系太难。
Are not Indians capable of being disciples？
我哋系咪问一个问题，就话印度人就冇资格系做主嘅门徒呢
？Are they some special case？
系咪佢哋系一个特殊嘅例子呢
？And as we began to pray together，
而当我哋不断祈祷嘅时间
，And as we shared these principles of spiritual life，
而当我哋分享到属灵生命一啲嘅原则嘅时间
，We discovered many Indians were more hungry for God and these realities than any of us were who came from the West。
咁我哋就发觉喺印度当中，其实有好多嘅信徒对神嗰个饥渴寻求嘅心，比喺西方嘅信徒仲有过之而无不及。
And that especially in the area of devotion and worship， that they had seemingly at times something that we often lacked from our workaholic Western world。
而特别呢班嘅印度嘅信徒，佢系对于敬拜，佢对于祈祷，系似乎有一啲嘅嘢喺我哋西方呢一班以工作为中心嘅一班嘅信徒系所缺少嘅。
And within 12 years，
十二年内
，these Indians had reached 150 million people with the word of God。
呢一班印度嘅信徒，佢哋将呢个福音系带出去，系带出去能够系达得到系接近1,500,000人。
They were reaching between 12 and 15 million people every year, preaching, mainly preaching, but also with literature.
而且他们一年里面，他是藉着文字，藉着报道，所能够达得到的人是接近1,200,000人。
Thousands went through the training program and are now working with almost every denomination and every major mission in all of India.
已经有几千个印度的信徒是经过这个门徒训练这个过程，而且跟着出去在不同的教会、不同的宗派、不同的机构里面来到负担传福音的工作。
And some areas those who were trained went on to plant new churches of new believers in those areas.
而有些接受了训练的就去到一些不同的地方，就开始建立一些新的教会，是开始传扬新福音，训练新的信徒。
And today there are 300 full-time workers with OM India.
在福音总动员这个工作当中，在印度这个地方已经有超过300位的同工。
Is discipleship possible today?
门徒训练是不是不可能的一件事？
I believe it is.
我觉得门徒训练是可能的。
And I believe that as we look out across the world today,
而当我们举目来到看整个世界的时间，
there is an increase of desire, especially among young people.
我们发觉在特别青年人当中有一种饥渴的心。
For taking that which we have in our heads and getting it down into the life.
就是将在头脑里面的知识能够转移成为一些生命的经历。
That which we read about in the book of Acts.
当我们在使徒行传里面去看回当中所发生的事。
The boldness in witness.
就是他们出到全福音那种的胆量。
The courage in claiming great things for God.
就是他们向神来求大事那种的信心和勇气。
The faith to do the impossible.
就是他们有信心依靠这位无难成的事的主。
The nights of prayer we read about in Acts 12.
我们在使徒行传第十二章看到他们是彻夜的祈祷。
The nights of praise that we read about in Acts 16.
在使徒行传第十六章我们看到他们彻夜地来到赞美神。
There is an increasing number of people who are hungry for this kind of reality in their own lives.
我们发觉成千成万的人其实都是很饥渴地来到寻找一种这样属灵的经历在他们的生命当中来到发生。
They're tired of the game of words. They're tired of just going through religious motion. They want reality. They want to know God. And they want God to be controlling their life.
他们已经听得太多他们知道太多他们都经过很多崇拜的仪式但他似乎在一个生命里面属灵的经历是非常的贫乏
I personally feel that I have a long way to go
我自己觉得神要我走的路还很远
And I've come to this conviction now that I'm in the middle years of my life
我自己也有一个感觉就我现在是踏入我侍奉的中年
And most of the realities of discipleship must be relearned again and again in one's life in different age brackets under different circumstances.
而当一个人进入人生不同的阶段的时间，似乎对门徒训练、门徒学习这样的东西，要重新不断更新地来到学习。
I'm rereading some of these books.
我的时间是再读我刚才所介绍这些书。
I say, Lord, now how does that apply for?A 20-year married man with three teenagers. How does this apply?
咁嘅時間，我睇嘅時間從一個唔同嘅角度，對一個已經結咗婚20年，有幾個咧已經十幾歲嘅細路仔嘅人，呢一段本嘅書又帶有咩意思呢
？Recently, I was reading a book called The Middle Years Crisis.
我最近係讀一本書，就講到中年人嘅危機。
I was actually feeling quite well until I read that book.
其实我一直都感觉得挺好的直到我看完那本书就觉得自己不太同
I think that book created a new crisis
我想那本书在我生命里面制造了一些危机
actually I've stopped reading it
所以我已经不读了
There are times when you have to stop reading books and go back to this one
所以很多时间有些书你看看你不看还好翻回来这一本
Yes, discipleship is possible today
门徒训练是可能的一件事
It's not some special little weird thing way out here for just a few little super saints
我们不是说门徒训练只不过是那些超级圣徒那些所特殊拥有的财产
It's God's way of life for every believer
是神给我们每一个信他的人的一种生命的样式
It doesn't mean you have to leave your beloved Hong Kong
我们甚至不需要离开我们所爱的香港
For some of you it may mean that
或者对其中一些人神给你的呼召是要离开这个地方
Certainly it seems to be a rather crowded place from the little I have seen
我虽然来了很短的时间但我已经感觉这个地方似乎很挤迫
And I'm so glad that your underground system opened completely yesterday for my arrival
我也很高兴特别为我的来临这个地下铁全线通车
And I just pray that as we go from this meeting tonight
所以我盼望大家当你离开今晚这个聚会之后
It will be in a spirit of seeking the Lord
就带着一个愿意寻求神这样的心
Saying Lord what would you do with my life
就对神说神啊你要在我的生命当中做一些什么呢
Is there some other country?
是不是你要我去另外一个国家
Is there some other thing I should be involved in right here?
或者有没有另外一个的事工是你感动我要投身的
Is there more that I can be doing right in my local church?
或者甚至在我自己本身的教会里面有没有一些新的东西你要我看得到
Which we deeply feel is God's key It's God's place for world evangelism
我们觉得神要透过教会来到做这个世界圣传福音的工作
And if at times you feel a little discouraged,
或者有时你会感觉到灰心
Just think of that one lady,
大家不要忘记那一位敬虔的妇人
And that one schoolboy,
还有那一个的学生
That one gospel of John,
就那一本福音约翰福音
What God was able to do,
神能够透过他们完成大事
And of course, this is only the beginning,
我们知道这个只不过是一个开始
Let us pray.
请大家低头，我们祈祷。
Let's have a moment of silent prayer in which we can make deeper commitments of our lives to the Lord Jesus Christ, even here.
我们低头静默祷告当中，我们重新将我们的生命献给我们的主。
Our God knows all about us, and He loves us still.
神知道我们生命的每一部分，但祂仍然爱我们。
So let us in silence just pour our hearts out in prayer and surrender and commitment to the Lord Jesus Christ.
所以在安静当中，我们将我们的心事都向神无保留地来倾吐。
Our God and Father, we thank you for this time together.
爱我们的父亲，我们多谢你给我们这个相聚的时间。
Lord, you know I have come here in great weakness and inadequacy.
神啊，你知道我是带着诸般的软弱和不足是来到这个地方。
There are so many things yet that I must learn and relearn in my own life.
在我自己个人的生命当中都有很多样的东西要重新的学习，不断的学习。
Lord, I thank you for your great patience with me.
神啊，我感谢你对我有这么大的容忍。
I thank you for your great love and mercy and acceptance.
神啊，感谢你对我有这么大的接纳。有这么大的饶恕。
Lord, I thank you this day for the privilege of even having some hours in this great land to the north of us.
也都多谢主给我有机会能够踏足中国大陆这个这么大的一个国家。
Lord, waken our hearts to a greater burden of prayer.
神啊，求你在我们的心中来到挑起一个祷告的负担。
Cause us in these days to surrender our life in a deeper way to you.
是叫我们在这些日子当中将我们的生命是更彻底的是委身于你。
Deliver us, God, from the subtle enslavements of the self-life that keep us from being what you want us to be.
所以很多时间我们以自我来做中心，以致我们不能够成为你所想要我们做的人。
Lord, fill us afresh with your Holy Spirit.
所以求你再一次用你的圣灵来充满我们。
That we may be as those men and women we read about in the book of Acts.
就叫我们重新好像使徒行传里面我们所看到的那班属于神的人一样。
And that compassion and communion with yourself may be the marks of our life.
叫他们向你那种迫切的心，向你那种追求的心，去成为我们生命当中的标志。
Strengthen your work around the world.
求神你再一次建立你在世界不同的地方的工作。
Raise up and send forth more laborers into training and into the harvest fields.
求神你兴起更多的工人，系打发佢哋进入工场里边。
For we pray in Jesus' name.
我哋奉主耶稣基督嘅名祈求。
Amen.